It's Brittany, and yes, I know this is like such a random video, a random upload, but since we're all quarantined right now, the world is literally on pause. It's scary out there. I'm gonna be uploading so much. So my uploading schedule doesn't even matter. I mean, there's still gonna be videos on Tuesdays and Saturdays, but there's gonna be more. There's gonna be like a video. Well, this video is going up on Monday. There's gonna be a video tomorrow, so Tuesday. There will probably be a video, I think, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. I'm just gonna be uploading so much. I'm feeling inspired, and I guess this is kind of a bonus video, but there's gonna be a lot more bonus videos during this time. So I hope you guys are all safe and healthy. I hope that you're washing your hands. I hope that y'all hand sanitizing your hands. Girl, I'm just enjoying my Coca-Cola, my Diet Coke, and my Las Vegas cup. Manifesting the crap out of my dreams. Anyways, so I wanted to make a video about this. Last week, I went to see, I almost said The Invisible. Do you remember The Invisible movie? That guy that was invisible, obviously. That was a good movie. That came out years ago. Hello, hello, can anybody hear me? Remember that line? That was a good movie. Anyways, The Invisible Man, I saw it last week, and I was like, you know what? I'm gonna make a video about this. I haven't made a video about a movie in forever. I used to always do movie reviews. Not really, I don't go into depth about it. I just tell you if I like it or if I don't like it. And I'm also worried about spoilers because I don't want people to be like, why would you say that? Even though I do give warnings if there is gonna be a spoiler in this, in the videos about movies. So there could be spoilers, so watch at your own risk and don't get mad if you haven't seen it. Like, you clicked on this video. That's all I'm saying. But I'm happy you're here. Hi. If you're new, please subscribe. I'm a paranormal channel, a paranormal investigator. My name is Brittany. I'm crazy, I'm fun, I'm bubbly, and I love the color pink. And I'm just like, I don't know, I'm feeling really good lately. Like, really good. I'm just like living. So I wanted to say, going into The Invisible Man, guys, I never watched the trailer. I did not. I watched that one clip when she's like, he's sitting in the chair. Or the guy was like, are you okay? And then she's like, sitting in the chair. So that's the only clip that I saw, and I never watched the trailer, which is very unusual because usually, like, seeing a movie, you watch a trailer. I mean, I know I do, I'm assuming you guys do too. And I just had this idea in my head that this was a paranormal movie. I thought The Invisible Man was an actual ghost. So I was like, oh, this is totally up my alley. Like, I never saw the trailer. I just kept replaying that scene in my head of her saying that he's sitting in the chair. And spoiler alert, that scene is not even in the movie. It's just in the trailer. Right? Because I remember after the movie was over, I was like, wait, that iconic scene was not in the actual movie, was it? Because I would have remembered that. That was the only thing I've seen. I had no idea there was an original Invisible Man, but this new version is like a different take on it. And I did not know that this is a Lee Whannell movie. I did not know that until I actually went. Well, actually before I went, like literally like 5 minutes before I went to go see it, I was like, oh my God, this is a Lee Whannell movie. I love Lee Whannell. I love his movies. Ever since Saw, I also had the biggest crush on him in 2004 when Saw came out. Was that 2004? Woo, girl. I remember coming home from school every day and I would watch Saw just to see Adam because I was in love with Lee Whannell. He was actually like a huge inspiration to me back in the day because I used to make my own horror films. Not really, I shouldn't even say that because it's literally just me and my camera. I was like the director, producer, and the actress, like the starring role and everything. But the fact that he, you know, wrote the Saw movies, he worked with James Wan, he starred in the first one, he was like the leading role, Adam, so I just was always very inspired by him. So when I found out this is one of his movies, I was so excited. And then seeing his name at the end of the credits, I was like, yes! Because I love him! So I just didn't even know it was a Lee Whannell movie. So these were all a bunch of surprises for me. So this movie stars Elizabeth Moss, and she was fantastic in this movie. Her acting was on point. She was fantastic. I thought she was great. And her character, Cecilia, is in an abusive relationship with this man named Adrian, and she's trying to escape. And he's just like crazy. He's super smart. And like, I get really... what I can say because I don't want to ruin it for people. But like I said, you clicked on this video so there could be spoilers. First of all, their house is freaking beautiful. It's in California, it's looking over the ocean, and it's just, ugh, I love the sound. I know this sounds really weird, but if you watch the movie, the sound of the ocean from their bedroom, I was living. So anyways, Adrian then dies. And she starts saying, you know, she starts feeling him around her and she believes that he is not dead. I absolutely love the scene when that introduces the Invisible Man. When Cecilia walks out of the house and it's cold, you can see her breath, but then you see the breath of somebody who's invisible right behind her, and that's like the first time you see the Invisible Man. I was like, what? That's him, you know? I would say I kind of started to lose interest after that, even though that part was really cool. I kind of forget what happened after that, but she's in the house or whatever. And I just started, I don't know, I was like, I guess this isn't gonna be that great. And then there's the scene in the attic because she's calling Adrian's phone and she hears it coming from the attic. That is so creepy. So that just, woo, I just came right back into it. I was on the edge of my seat at this point. And then she's up in the attic, and then in the trailer you see she throws the paint and then you see the Invisible Man, but he's not so invisible anymore. So then I was like, okay, this is cool, this is cool. But then I started losing interest again at this other part with the Invisible Man. I was like, I don't know, this is kind of dumb. Literally, that's what I was thinking. And then you start feeling for Cecilia because everyone around her thinks that she's crazy. And then I started thinking, okay, like, is she crazy? Is this all just like the Invisible Man's not really invisible and it's all in her head kind of thing? So that's what I started thinking. But you know what? I was really feeling for her because all these things were happening around her. Things that she was being blamed for, like murders. Oh my God, that restaurant scene. That I was caught off guard. That was freaky. And I just felt for her because obviously there's security cameras. Like, someone just needs to watch a security camera of that restaurant to see that Cecilia did not do what she was accused of doing. And then, like, she's in a mental hospital. And I was really feeling for her. So this Invisible Man is after her and following her. So when she's in the mental hospital, finally, one of the guards, because she's like fighting the Invisible Man, she knows where he is, she can feel him. She's like, I can see you. And one of the guards came in and then he could see because she stabbed him in his suit. As soon as the security guard, now I feel like I'm just like giving away the whole movie, I don't know. Whatever, you clicked on this movie or you clicked on this video, like I said. But anyways, so when the guard is in her room with her and sees the Invisible Man, I was like, yes, finally. Finally, someone can see that she is not crazy. And then I love the whole scene in the hallway at the mental hospital with all the guards, and the Invisible Man is just going through each of the guards one by one and just like, you know what I mean? I love that. I love the way this movie was shot. I thought the acting was great. And I would say from the mental hospital scene and going to the end of the movie, I loved it and I chose to love it because at first I was like, oh, this is dumb. I really was thinking that. And I heard so many great things about this movie prior to seeing it. I never heard one negative thing about it. So I was like, oh my God, this is gonna be great. Even though I only saw that one scene from the trailer before going, but then when I got home and then I watched the trailer, I was like, oh, it makes sense. It's not a paranormal movie. It's more of a thriller, you know? The ending I thought was fantastic. I'm not gonna say what happened. But then I remember in the kitchen scene when all this stuff is going on with Cecilia, I was like, holy crap, this is really a ghost? Like, this is insane. Like, she's being dragged across the floor. Like, all the things that I want to happen to me, you know, at haunted locations. So I was like, whoa, this is crazy. But that's when I started thinking, okay, this can't, I don't think this is paranormal. And then, like, when you see the suit and stuff like that. So when she throws the paint, I was like, oh, you know. But anyways, yeah, this movie was great. I don't know what else to say. Lee Whannell, like, he's amazing. The cast was amazing, and it just kept you on the edge of your seat. There's a lot of twists and turns, but I think just because I thought it was a paranormal movie, at the, you know, I just had those moments like, okay, this is, I don't think I like it, you know? But no, it got really good, and then when it ended, you know, I'm still thinking about that ending, but when it ended, I was like, my jaw was open. I was like, this was really good. I loved it. What would I rate it? I'm not good with that. Usually I'm like, it's a 10, it's 11 out of 10, you know, because I'm too nice. I'll give it an 8.5. I don't know. Okay, honestly, I guess not a 10 because of my feelings and, like, you know. I thought it was great, though. Like, if you want to see this movie, I definitely recommend. It was great. It was really good. I want to see it again. And I think if you see it for a second time, you will notice more things. I mean, that's like with every single movie. The more you watch it, even with TV shows, the more things you start to notice and everything. But is that all I wanted to say? It was great! So I guess 8.5, that's great. That's a good out of 10. I'm not a movie reviewer. I just like to talk about movies sometimes. This is random, I know. So I hope that you guys are excited for my extra videos that are coming out. I have a video coming out tomorrow, which is my night vision footage from the Marshall House. Uncut. I've always wanted to do an uncut video, so you guys will see that, like, especially for investigations. And then this Saturday, of course, will be episode 3 of Birdie 44's Fear Takes on Savannah, Georgia. This time, episode 3, we are at the East Bay Inn. It will be a premiere on my channel, so 2:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Saturday. Another premiere. I had so much fun at the last premiere with you guys. Thank you for coming. Thank you for chatting in the chat. I'm always in the live chat, so if you want to chat with me live while watching episode 3, then definitely come on by. It's a lot of fun. I have so much fun with you guys. You guys are so freaking nice. So thank you so much for watching. As always, you rock my world. And the song lyrics, Michael Jackson. Hashtag team, Birdie44. Hashtag Bobrutha Burns. Hey. And I will see you guys in tomorrow's video. My night vision footage. And I'll see you guys almost every single day for like the next like 3 weeks or so. So I hope you guys are having a great day. Stay safe. Wash your hands, sanitize your hands, be positive, and I will see you guys tomorrow.